Okay, today we will be making competitive Pokémon for Sword and Shield. How to breed them, how to train them, and anything in between. So, first we need to choose the Pokémon we want, according to the team we want to build, the current ladder, or just because we like a specific Pokémon. In my case, I want a Togekiss, so I will go through 7 steps to make a perfect competitive one. The first step is to choose an ability. To know the options we have, we will go to cerebi.net, which is in the description, and search for the Pokémon you want. Select the one from Sword and Shield, scroll down, and in abilities we will have different options, the common abilities and the hidden one. I want the hidden one in this case. So now, how do we obtain this Pokémon? The best way is to get it from dens. To see from which dens we can obtain them, we will go to this link, which is also in the description down below. Here, we will search for the Pokémon we want. As you can see, there are 2 boxes. The ones on the left are from common dens, and the ones on the right are from rare dens. If you want a hidden ability like me, it's easier to get it from the rare dens. So my Togekiss is on den 87, which is on Bridgefield, as we can see in the image. And if we click on him, we will see that it has a 15% chance of spawning as a 5-star. And it is possible to get a hidden ability from him. Now, let's go capture him. So, go to your game and we are going to search for Bridgefield on the map. Go there. And now we need to find the den according to the image we saw on Cerebi. So, let's go find it. Now that we have located it, we need to spawn a rare den. And we will need fast reflexes for this part, and at least one wishing piece. If this is your first time doing this, go to the main menu, options, and change the text speed to slow or
normal,
so you can get a hang of it. I will keep it as it is. Save the game, and now we are ready. Click on the den, click yes, and as soon as you click yes a second time, for a split second, you will see a light coming out of the den. If it is red, it means it's a common den, which in my case, I don't want. So, as soon as you see it, hit the home button and close the game, before it saves automatically. Now, let's go in and try it again. Doing this, we won't lose the wishing piece, so we have infinite tries. Continue doing this process until you see a different light coming out of the den. A pink light, like this one. This is a rare den. They appear one in about every 10 attempts. Now that we have spawned it, you can change the speed text back to fast. Save the game. We need to search for the Pokémon we want in this den. To do so, first we have to be offline. Then we will see what Pokémon have spawned. If you don't want it, like this one, we will click on invite others. Hit the home button. System settings. Go all the way down to system. Date and time, we desynchronize the clock, date and time again, and we move a day forward. Click OK, hit the home button again to go to the main menu and return to our game. Now we click quit, and when we enter the den once again, we will have a different Pokémon available. We need to continue doing this process until we get the Pokémon we want. This could take a time, so just keep it up.
Much later.
Finally, we encountered the Togekiss. Before we begin, let's change the date back to normal. And now let's fight this Togekiss and see if it has the hiding ability. So it has the ability we want, but it is a male. And we need a female. This is because the female determines the Pokémon it hatches from the eggs. In this case, if we want a Togepi, we need a female Togekiss. What we can do is breed this Togekiss with a Ditto until we get a female Togepi with the hiding ability. So continuing on, we save and proceed to the next step. By the way, if it didn't have the ability, what we had to do is close the game without saving and re-enter. This way, our rare den will restart, so we can once again do the same thing with the day skip until we get the Pokémon we want with the ability we want. For the second step, we need to know the egg moves that are available for our Pokémon. These moves can only be learned by being transferred from the parent to the offspring, and we can only transfer 4 of them. So, let's return to Celebi.net, scroll down to egg moves, and here we can see the different attacks we can transfer. In my case, I want Psycho Shift, Extra Sensory, and Morning Sun. So, click on Details. Here we will see the Pokémon that can breathe with our Togekiss, and also learn the attacks that we want to transfer to the offspring. In this case, I need a male Noctowl and Cherubi. If I click on them, we can see at which level they learn the attacks we want. These Pokémon can be obtained either in the wild or through dens. Now, these attacks can only be transferred if they are in the main 4 attack slots of the Pokémon. So, once captured, we need to go to any Pokécenter and talk to the guy on the left, so our Pokémon can remember the attacks we want. As you can see, in my case, I had to make Noctowl relearn Psycho Shift, and now it has both attacks I need. It's time to transfer those attacks to our Togepi, so go to the daycare and put both Pokémon together, the female Pokémon with the ability we want, and the male Pokémon with the attacks we want. The offspring should have the ability and attacks of the parents. As a note, remember, the abilities of the newborns can always change, so continue breeding until an offspring inherits the ability you want. Now I have a newborn female Togepi, with the ability of the mother and the egg moves of the father. But now I need to transfer the third attack, Morning Sun, from the Cherubi. So once again, we put together the female Togepi we just got, which I evolved to Togetic, and the male Cherubi to continue breeding. As I said before, for me, these 3 are all the egg moves I want to transfer, so the gender of this offspring should not matter. But if you want to continue breeding more egg moves, then you need a female Togepi. Finally, we have the Togepi we want with the attacks of both fathers and the hidden ability of the mother. Now we can proceed to the next step. In the third step, we have to choose a nature. These natures modify 2 stats of a Pokémon. The stat in red is increased by 10%, while the blue one is decreased by 10%. Now, these percentages are applied to the total stat number of a Pokémon. So, if we have a Pokémon with 300 attack, the nature boost will increase it to 330. Here's a table with all the natures there exist. We should choose a nature that boosts whatever stat we want, but decreases stat we don't need. In my case, I want to boost Togekiss' physical defense. And as a special attacker, he doesn't need or use physical attacks. So I will go with a ball nature, which increases defense and decreases attack. To transfer these natures, we need to breed our Pokémon again. One of the parents will transfer his nature to the offspring, only if he holds an Everstone while being in the daycare. I recommend to capture a lot of Dittos until you have all the natures you want. In my case, I will give an Everstone to a Ditto with a ball nature, and breed him with my Togepi I got at the end of the second step. With this method, the nature is transferred 100% of the time, so we should only need 1 egg. But be sure the newborn's ability is the correct one, because that one can still change. Like in this case, the first Togepi has the ball nature, but the ability is Serene Grace, and I want the Super Lock ability. So we have to continue. The second Togepi though does have the ability I want, and the nature, so we have concluded this step. And for the next steps, we will be giving the Everstone to whoever has the correct nature. Now, we begin the step that will take us the longest to get through, the fourth step, IVs. To put it simple and avoid going too in-depth, IVs can increase each stat of our Pokémon up to 15 points, if our Pokémon is level 50, and 31 points if it's level 100. To get this maximum total points increased, our IV description has to say best. So we are aiming to get the best value description on every stat. Something important to know when going for a perfect Pokémon is that, like in my case, Togekiss is a special attacker, so it doesn't use his physical attack. But there could be enemy attacks like Full Play that uses our Pokemon attack stat to do more damage. So if we don't need the attack stat, like my Togekiss, we have to reduce it as much as we can, so we receive less damage from these kind of attacks. To do so, we will aim for a bad attack stat IV value, like no good or decent. No good represents 0 IVs, while decent varies from 1 to 15 out of the 31. Okay, now how do we get these IVs? Through breeding, once again. The parents can transfer their IVs to the offspring. If one of the parents, it doesn't matter which, holds a Destiny Knot item while in the daycare. Now, with this method, we will transfer 5 IV stats out of the 6, and they are chosen randomly between the IVs of both parents. So, the offspring can have the HP of the father, the attack of the mother, so far and so on. But, as I said, it only inherits 5 of them. The 6th one will be generated randomly, without taking the parents on consideration, and it can be any stat. So, now that we know how it works, let's make it happen. Like I said before, I have captured a bunch of Dittos to get different natures, but also to get different IV combinations to transfer to whatever Pokemon I want. So I will take the Ditto with no good attack stat, make him hold the Destiny Knot, then give the Everstone to the Togepi we got in the last step with the nature we want, and put them together in the daycare. Now the more tedious process of them all starts right here. We will be breeding a lot of eggs until we get the one with perfect IVs. For me, it will be with every IV stat saying best, and the attack stat saying no good. So let's speed this up. Okay, the first egg, as you can see, has better IVs than the one we leave in the daycare. We could exchange it to get more accurate IVs from the offsprings. But the thing is, it doesn't have the ability we want, Super Luck. Remember, the ability can still change. So, this Togepi is no good. Let's continue. Now, this one has better IVs than the one in the daycare, and it also has the ability we want, so we will exchange this one with the one in the daycare to increase the chances of getting the IVs we want from the offsprings. Let's take out the one from the daycare, give the Everstone to the new one, and put him on the daycare with Ditto. We will continue doing this every time we get an offspring with better IVs than the parent, to increase our chances of getting the perfect one. Remember, this could take a lot of time, be patient. So, let's speed this up!
1 eternity later.
So, after a lot of time and a lot of breathing, these are my results. 2 Togepis with 6 IVs and different abilities, 1 with the IVs I want, but the Serene Grace ability, and just 1 completely perfect. It has the egg moves I want, the hidden ability, and the IVs. So you know the struggle I went through, these are all the boxes I filled trying to get the one. 7 boxes full of Togepis. I have to say this is one of the worst lucks I have had. Other times I have not filled even one box when I got the IVs I wanted, but it happens. You can either trade all those boxes on surprise trades, or just delete them.
I'm sorry, little one.
Okay, so finally, we finished this. Let's get to the next step. 5th step, EVs. Okay, so let me try to explain EVs in a simple way. Each Pokemon has a total of 510 EVs you can distribute between any stat. But the maximum amount of EVs a stat can have is 252. Now, these 252 EVs represent 32 stat points at level 50 and 62 at level 100. So to put it simple, if your Pokemon level 50 has an attack stat of 300 and you invest 252 EVs on that stat, his attack will increase to 332. This means you can invest that total of 510 EVs in any amount, maximum 252, to any stat you want. If you want to know how these EVs will affect your Pokemon in battle before committing on the investment, check out these web pages. The links will be in the description down below. Here you can test different EV combinations, simulate the damage between you and an enemy, so you don't screw up on the real game. Okay, now that we know this, how do we increase the EVs of a Pokemon? Easy, through the Pokejobs. Go to any Poke Center, talk to the robot on PC, and if you already beat the game, these 6 Pokejobs will be available. Each of them increase certain EV stat by 92 points. If you leave the Pokemon a whole day, and you can put up to 10 Pokemon per Pokejob. The amazing thing about this is that we can use the day skip exploit so we don't have to wait 24 hours, but just a few minutes, even seconds. To activate the exploit, first you need to switch on handheld mode. Connect to the internet. Select Link Battle, Single Battle. And as the searching process starts, we will hit and hold the home button. When a message appears saying a trainer has been found, click and change the airplane mode to on, followed by an error message. Now change airplane mode back to off. Click cancel and a blue screen should appear by an instant, confirming the exploit was a success. And that's it. Now we can skip days as we please. These are the EVs I want for my Togekiss. You can go for whatever you want for your Pokemon. Now we go to the Rotom PC, click on Pokejobs. Select the one from the stat we want. Select up to 10 Pokemon. Click the B button, select I'm done. Send Pokemon a whole day. The Pokemon are now going to be sent. So let's move one day forward. Click the home button. System settings. Go all the way down to system. Date and time. Desynchronize the clock. Date and time. And move one day forward. Click OK. Press the home button again and return to the game. Now, when we enter the Pokejobs, the ones completed should appear in red. If there's nothing ready, just wait a little longer. It could take a minute. Now, we will receive our Pokemon back and gain 92 EVs on that stat if you send them the whole day. So let's do the same thing again until we acquire and invest all the 510 EVs the Pokemon has. And if you want less than 92 EVs, here are the different EV amounts we get for each session we send them. To see the EVs of the Pokemon, we will click on their summary. Go to the stat tab, press the X button, and we will see the investment in an orange or naive color. If a stat reaches the 252 cap, the stat name will shine with sparkles. With this, we put an end to the more complex steps of this tutorial. So let's get to the next one. In this 6th step, we will decide which attacks our Pokemon will have. We can go to Celebi.net to see all the attacks our Pokemon can learn and how are they learned. By leveling up as a TM or as a TR. And in the Max Move section, we can see all the secondary effects of every type of move. So choose wisely. I will use my Togekiss as a support, so I will make him learn Follow Me, Helping Hand, Dazzling Gleam, and Air Slash. The egg moves that we lose here can be relearned by going with the guy that reminds attacks on the Poke Center. So don't worry about them. You can use them whenever you want. Finally, the last step. Here we will level up our Pokemon. We will only use this to make them evolve or to learn an attack. Remember, if you will use this Pokemon to play in online battles, you don't have to level him up, because the level and stats are increased or decreased either to level 50 or 100, even if your Pokemon is level 1. The fastest way to level up a Pokemon is through XP candies. You get them by doing raids, and as I said, use them just enough to either make them evolve or to learn an attack. There is no need to get them to 100 for online battles. You can also keep using the Pokéjobs. There are ones that increase level instead of EVs. If you know a faster way to level up your Pokémon or any tips on this, please let me know on the comment section below. So at the end, this is how my Togekiss looks. After all this process, it has the hidden ability, nature, attacks, IVs and EVs I want. So now we just need to give him an item that fits his role in the team. So if you are ready to go competitive, let me know by clicking the like button. If not, and you have questions about any of this, please let me know on the comment section below. And subscribe for more content like this, or even better content. This is the second video I have ever created, and there is a lot of improvement to be made. So, see you later!